Welcome to Product Overview video on S-Concrete, our intuitive concrete section design tool. We pride ourselves on having S-Concrete used around the world by thousands of different engineers. Our support for many international design codes accommodates a diverse global client base. S-Concrete cuts down on the lengthy task of manual hand calculations, and its integration with F-Stream analysis and reporting software makes S-Concrete a very powerful tool. Unparalleled ease of use is something that sets S-Concrete apart from its competitors. Instantaneous code check results make it good for design and sensitivity analysis. We can do manual or automated design of reinforced concrete sections. And the comprehensive reporting feature makes S-Concrete a very powerful tool for sharing information with others. If we switch over to S-Concrete's user interface, we get a sense to see how simple the program is laid out. We can take a look at the different shapes available, different T and L-shaped beams, as well as rectangular, as well as different column sections, and a variety of walls. We're going to just use a simple rectangular section for this case. And if you go into the Edit Loads window, we can take a look at the loading that's been applied to this section. You can see we have axial, torsional, shear, and moment loads that we can apply. I'm okay with the defaults. I'm going to click OK. And if we go to the top of the screen, we notice that we have a status bar. It says unacceptable. We have a shear and torsional utilization and an axial load and moment utilization. It's the axial load and moment that we're concerned with. So we'll have to do some redesigning. If I go under Edit Section, this is where I can edit the section itself, the dimensions, the exposure, material properties, as well as the units, building or concrete code, and even the shear method used for the CSA. If I go under Edit Reinforcing, this is where I can edit the different reinforcing patterns that I have in detailing. I can edit the top bars or bottom bars individually, as well as the stirrups and face steel. And when I make any changes, the code check will update automatically. I can also adjust my section in the Visual Editor window by simply dragging any one of the lines, and you'll notice that the code check utilizations update instantaneously. The same can be done for reinforcing, just simple right and left clicks, either take away or add additional steel, and again the code check will update instantaneously. I'm still concerned as to why my section is failing. I can open up a results report and scroll to the bottom, and I'll get a list of messages as to why, according to the code checks, this section is failing. It even gives clause references given the building code or the concrete code that you've defined, making it easy to double check and verify your results. If we scroll up, there's more information on the calculations that have gone on in S-Concrete. Again, this is in place so that if you ever have any doubt about your design, you can always go back and double check it by hand. Since we are still achieving an unacceptable status, I'm going to go and run an automated design. But first I have to set up my constraints. So here I can set up my beam size, whether or not I want to keep a certain window of bar sizes available. For instance, I may not want to go over a 15mm stirrup, so I'll set that as a constraint. And once I'm satisfied with all those constraints, I can run an automated design. S-Concrete gives me a summary of my existing condition, and it'll let me know that right now I'm asking S-Concrete to run a maximum of 25 iterations before it finds a design. And you can see in this case it only took S-Concrete 5 iterations to find an acceptable design that was within the utilization factor of 1. And this is what I ended up with. I can view the report again and just double check, make sure there's no warnings or anything that may cause some problems with using this design. I can also go through and double check the calculations and just make sure everything looks as to what I would expect. And if I was interested, I could even adjust the section or the reinforcing bars some more. If we're satisfied with this design, we can share it with others using tools such as our Dxf export. It's as simple as creating a Dxf file and then viewing it in the Dxf viewer. As you saw, the ease of use is emphasized by the efficiency-focused GUI, which makes for quick learning. Sensitivity analysis and manual design are quick due to the immediate feedback of code check results. Having the option to do either a manual or automated design increases your productivity and allows you to experiment with more designs. And the ability to share your designs with others makes S-Concrete a very powerful design aid and reporting tool. If you'd like more information on S-Concrete, you'll be pleased to know that we have 3 additional videos on each of beams, columns, and walls, and they can be found on our website. If you're interested in purchasing the software, please contact us. Thank you.